friends, how are you all? I hope that you all are very well. But I am not well today, I am having cold. But I have to teach you because it's an important thing. I have to prepare video for you guys. So today I am here with some more exciting points, some more exciting theories, some more exciting name. So get ready with your pen and copy and note down each and every important thing which I am telling you in the video, so that they will help you in your exam. Today's topic is very, very simple topic. No, it's a very easy topic of cytology, but you have to learn it. You have to memorize it properly. Otherwise, it will be very tough for you. You will get direct questions from this topic. Okay, so as you can see here, that our first topic is the cell theory. We will study the original cell theory, then we will study the objections after that on that cell theory, and after that we will study the modern cell theory. Okay, these three things we will cover in this video, so watch complete video very sincerely and note down each and every point. I know that it will definitely help you a lot. So let's start this exciting journey. Cell theory is given by three great scientists, that is Sladen, Schön and Virgo. These three scientists worked on that cell theory. What was their role? We will study in later slide. Okay, just remember the name of scientist. Let me show you their pictures also, how they look. Okay, here's Schön, and he's a Sladen, and he is Virgo. And here is your happy cell. It's here. Every cell organelle is smiling. Look at nucleus, mitochondria, Golgi body, endoplasmic reticulum. Everyone is smiling here. It's a happy cell. And after watching this video, you will also smile like this. Okay, nice ears. So you have seen the name of scientist, you have seen the pictures of scientists. Let's move towards the point which they have given, which are actually very important, which we have to study. This is the cell theory, guys. Where I put my camera? I think this is the right position. So here you can see Matthias Sladen, a German botanist. He was a German botanist. And Theodor Schön, a German zoologist, jointly proposed cell theory in 1839. Remember this year. This year is very important. Okay. This, what they have states in their cell theory, they states that all living organisms are made of one or more cells. We have studied in previous video that organism can be unicellular or multicellular, both. So that is a very simple line, easy line. You can learn it very easily or very quickly. You can say that all organisms are made up of either one cell or so many cells. That is a very simple one. I think first point is memorized. Now move towards the second point. All cells are the basic units of structure and functions. I have already told you that a single cell has the capacity to perform all the functions which are required for a life process. So this point is also very simple one. Now cell performs vital activities of an organism. It performs all kind of vital activities. Whatever activities are going inside a body, that are performed by the cells, or a group of cells, you can say. Clear? Now one very, very important term is now coming. I have to highlight that term. Let me use highlighter and color also, it should be yellow, I think. Very important term is that omnicellular e-cellular. Directly question will come, okay? Directly examiner asks the question from that term. That is omnicellular e-cellular. And it is also called as cell lineage theory. That is cell lineage theory. Both both term is very, very important. And who gave this? That is given by Rudolf Virchow. Few often say that Rudolf Virchow, but I love to say that Rudolf Virchow. In 1855, remember the year, remember the scientist's name and what he has given. That is the ominous cellula, E-cellula. What does it mean, guys? It means that new cells are arising from the pre-existing one. I know that that is a very simple line at this time, but at that time in that year, that was a very big line, you know. He has discovered a completely new things. No one know that thing at that time. So he has explained that new cell arises from pre-existing cells. And what is that? Omnicellular E-cellular. Now I think that is clear to you, that what you have to remember in that cell theory. You have to remember the scientist's name and the first point which he has given, that all living organisms are made up of one or more cell. It can be unicellular and multicellular both. And all cells are the basic units of structure and functions. We have already studied that. And cells perform vital activities of organism. And the most important thing, which is what is here? That is, new cells arises from pre-existing cell, that point. And what term we use for that? That is ominous cellula, E-cellula. And what's the name of that theory? That is the cell lineage theory. And who has given that theory? That is Rudolf Virchow in year 1855. So that is all about the main cell theory. Now let's move towards the objections on this cell theory. What objections just come? Objections are actually very good, because when objections will come at that time, you will discover new things, new discoveries will occur at that time. So they are good also. Now first objection is that RBCs and sieve tube cells live without nucleus. We are continuously saying that each and every cell having nucleus in case of eukaryotic cell. But RBCs and sieve tube cells don't have nucleus. So that is the first objection. And viruses are acellular and do not contain cellular machinery. I will prepare a separate video for viruses. But right now I am telling you one line, that viruses are between the link of living and non-living. They come under both types. They can be living and non-living both. When they get suitable condition, they become living at that time. And when the conditions, environmental condition I'm talking about, when the environmental conditions are against them at that time, they behave or they act just like the non-living. So they are just like a connecting link between the living and non-living organism. So that is the second objection. Bacteria do not bear nucleus and membrane-bound organelles. Bacteria, it means we are talking about the prokaryotes here. So they don't have nucleus. Their genetic material is completely free in their cytoplasm. There is no boundary around its nucleus. And there are also no membrane-bound cell organelles are present. We have already studied in previous video of prokaryotic cell. I think you remember that thing. So that is the third objections. These all three objections are really true. So after these objections, they propose the new cell theory, which is also known as the modern cell theory, you can say, or cell doctrine or cell principle. You can name anyone. It can, or you can say it can come from any name in your exam. Okay, I think that's all about this video. And I am attaching a PDF with that video so that you will learn the cell organelles discoverer. As I have already taught the cell organelles and their discoverer in previous videos, but here I am mentioning each and every cell organelle along with their discoverers. So you can learn it easily. It's around 20 to 25 scientist name and approximate, I am telling. So you can download that PDF from PDF and it will help you very much, believe me. So get ready for the next video, that is on the cell theory. and you will learn cell theory in a very, very exciting way. So that's all for this one. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel Biomania, and if you like the video, press the like button and share with your friends so that they can also learn in a easy manner. So thank you so much. Bye bye.